Greetings, fellow detectives. Wizard Kitten here, bringing you a new Nancy Drew analysis video. Today's video is brought to you by the patrons over at Mystique Manor and by all the official Fellow Detective channel members. If you too would like to support the channel and gain access to exclusive features, check out patreon.com/wizardkitten to become a patron, or click join next to the subscribe button to become an official Fellow Detective. I have always considered it seriously impressive that a point-and-click video game series could make me emotional. Beyond being excellent mysteries, the Nancy Drew PC games also have some serious emotional value to them, and some incredible storytelling. While the title of this video may be a slight exaggeration for me in that they haven't actually brought me all the way to tears, there are so many moving moments in the games that truly made my heart ache. I do also know from chats with fellow detectives that these games are legitimately tear-inducing, so this video is to celebrate our emotional sides. Let's delve into 6 Nancy Drew moments that pull on my heartstrings. Also, fair warning, please expect spoilers for the following 6 Nancy Drew games in no particular order. You have been warned. Number 6, reading Kate Drew's letter to Little Nancy in The Silent Spy. There are a lot of things that I wish were different about this game, including that I wish the focus of the entire game had been on Nancy's mom and not a whole host of peripherally related nonsense. However, the parts that were about Nancy's mom were genuinely touching. By the end of the game, Nancy has learned that her mother's death wasn't an accident, that she had died while on duty as a spy, and that she had more or less sacrificed herself to thwart a terrorist attack. This alone is a wild revelation. But Nancy also finds a letter that Kate Drew wrote to young Nancy in the event of her passing. This is easily the core heart of The Silent Spy, and the letter itself is beautifully written and incredibly moving. To summarize, Kate essentially tells Nancy that her goofy uniqueness is valuable, brave, and something to cherish. She tells Nancy to be herself and to take on the world with courage, which is just so sweet considering who Nancy has become, an international detective who has thwarted dozens of would-be criminals. Every child just wants to hear from their parents that they are good and worthy and loved. And for Nancy to be able to hear that from her mother after so long, it's tear-inducing. Number 5, learning about Dexter Egan's relationship to his adopted father, Ezra Wickford, in Treasure in the Royal Tower. What I love about this tear-inducing moment is that it is entirely nonverbal. Through some clever snooping, Nancy can uncover Ezra Wickford's secret study within the library. In this room, Nancy finds mementos of Dexter's childhood and his adopted father, something that we didn't know previously in the game. We find that the relationship was beautiful at times, with loving scrapbooks and memorabilia, but that the relationship was also strained as Dexter grew older. Ezra eventually disowned Dexter and almost entirely cut him out of his life, and imagining the heartbreak and trauma of that situation is just gut-wrenching. The emotional weight further increases when we talk to Dexter about what we found. It's so clear that little Dexter was going through a tough time and didn't know how to handle it. Meanwhile, old Dexter is racked with guilt and regret. It's just such a human story about forgiveness, acceptance, and moving on. And it gets me every time. Number 4, Harper Thornton speaking about the loss of her sister, Charlotte Thornton, in Ghost of Thornton Hall. There are a lot of moving moments in this game, but none more so for me than the conversation with Harper, in which she utters this powerful line. "Golden child, Charlotte. She was perfect in everyone's eyes, even mine. I wanted to be her when I grew up. But then, one day, I was older than my older sister, and older still today." Ah, it's so sad. And it's such a beautifully written line, profound and meaningful without needing to be so direct about what happened. Within this conversation and throughout the entire game, we see the toll that losing her older sister took on Harper. Furthermore, Harper had also lost both of her parents in a tragic accident, and this game does such a wonderful job dissecting the pain and grief that accompanies such huge and unexpected losses. Number 3, opening Gunnar's box in Sea of Darkness. Gunnar has been a gruff and grumbly character throughout his game, but when Elizabeth kicks him out of the pub, he asks Nancy to retrieve a box of his. Nancy naturally takes a peek inside, only to find out a big part of why Gunnar struggles so much. While boating with his family, his wife and daughter, the boat wrecks, and Gunnar is the only one to survive. As a sailor and fisherman, someone who has spent countless hours on the water, Gunnar is racked with guilt and absolutely tragic loss. This small moment builds so much empathy for Gunnar as a character and becomes the heart of an already warm and moving mystery. The conversation that we have with Gunnar afterwards provides even more pathos, as he realizes how his pain has been making him behave. It's fascinating and deeply moving. Number 2, reading Meryl Humber's diary in Secret of Shadow Ranch. Listen, the writing and voice acting of Meryl Humber's diary is simply masterful. Inconsistently throughout the Nancy Drew games, voice actors will read aloud letters or diary entries as the character who did the writing. This is one of those instances, and the voice actor absolutely nailed it. The diary entries start out by describing a happy, close, and loving relationship between Meryl and his daughter, Frances. He then transitions to a gently gruff and protective dad tone when he realizes Frances has eyes for someone named Dirk. That gruff and protective dad tone intensifies when he realizes that Dirk is actually a wanted outlaw. Meryl, as sheriff, then finds out about a meeting between the two lovers and captures Dirk, who then hangs for his crimes. Frances, heartbroken and outraged, leaves, never to return. The diary entries become regretful, then deeply sad, until finally spattered tear stains show just how lonely and ashamed Meryl feels by the end. This diary is one of the most brilliant items and moments in any Nancy Drew game. Not only does it fill us in on a great deal of necessary context, but it also tells us about it from the perspective of a secondary character with a completely different vantage point of the situation. It's fascinating, it's heartbreaking, it's nuanced, and it's absolutely tear-inducing. Number 1, seeing Henry Bollet crying at the door to his parents' crypt in Legend of the Crystal Skull. I have racked my brain, and I am pretty sure that this is the only time that we ever see a physical character cry in the Nancy Drew series. And let me tell you, it hits. Nancy is just casually snooping around the vast cemetery when all of a sudden she stumbles across Henry Bollet on his knees, sobbing to the entrance of his parents' crypt. He notices Nancy, rubs his eyes, and runs away, never mentioning the situation to Nancy, and she never breaching the subject. This is devastating. Henry has dealt with so much loss and isolation in his life, and after the death of his great uncle, with literally no trusting person to talk to, he lets it all out in the graveyard. It's so human, and there really is something powerful about him being the only character that we ever see cry in the series. I immediately want to run after Henry and give him a hug, or at the very least give him someone who can listen to his sorrows. It's so sad and devastatingly human. So, there you have it, fellow detectives. 6 moments in the Nancy Drew series that provide gut-wrenching, tear-inducing pathos, at least in my opinion. There were several honorable mentions that I think could have been included as well, like reading Kasumi Shimizu's letters to her daughters in Shadow at the Water's Edge, or Caitlin Malloy's diary entry right before her demise in Haunting of Castle Malloy. There are also several moments that I think are written for a bigger emotional punch that don't really stick the landing, like Xenia Dukas's Out of the Blue Melancholy Conversations in Labyrinth of Lies. Overall, though, I think the Nancy Drew series does a really wonderful job of incorporating emotional, thoughtfully written moments throughout the games. The storytelling is superb in so many ways, including those that can bring us to tears. But what do you think, fellow detectives? Did the moments that I chose make you emotional? What moments in the series have made you cry or broke your heart? What moments did I not include on this list that you think should have made it? Let a wizard kitten know in the comment section down below. If you really enjoyed this video, please consider hitting that like button or tipping me for the video with a super thanks next to the download button right beneath the video. If you would like to come join a fantastic group of fellow detectives at Mystique Manor as a patron for the channel, gain access to exclusive content, and support the making of more content like this, please check out patreon.com/wizardkitten. I also have channel memberships with exclusive badges and emojis to use during streams and in the comment section. If you'd like to support the channel by becoming an official fellow detective, click join next to the subscribe button. Please feel free to follow the channel on Instagram or Discord, linked in the description box down below. And as always, please feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more Nancy Drew and Sims 4 content. Thank you so much for watching, fellow detectives. I will see you soon.